summer switches, she was here. The fire dropped into the water and ignited. She run and tell her parents that ghost is down here, the water is on fire.
Ah.
Her parents tell her, no, this is where the ancestors come and get the healing whenever time they get good. Scientists came here drilling it, looking for oil and gas, they didn't find it. You could eat it and underneath it, don't burn.
The primary aim of this video is to present the layman with 1. A basic understanding of the geology of the Windsor Spring and surroundings. 2. Applicable insight into the potential geologic setting of Jamaica's offshore, the area of interest for hydrocarbon exploration. At this stage, you should be aware that the Windsor Spring, or the firewater that is witnessed at the Windsor Spring, is as a result of methane seepage. This methane is natural gas, a hydrocarbon. With Professor Mitchell confirming that the methane seepage at the Windsor Spring is an indication of a hydrocarbon system underground, here is the first definition. Hydrocarbon system is one that involves the occurrence, migration, and usage of the hydrocarbons. What is evident at the Windsor Spring is the migration or escape of the hydrocarbon methane. Source rock, one that contains organic material that can be heated to produce oil or gas. Reservoir rock, a porous and permeable one that can store fluids such as oil, water, and gas. Cap rock, a non-permeable layer that holds the hydrocarbon in place, or in other words, prevents it from escaping. With this diagram as illustration, what you should keep in mind is that it is the interplay of source rock, reservoir rock, and cap rock, plus migration factors such as the tectonic system, i.e. earthquakes as an example, that make up a petroleum system. What you should keep in mind is the statement made in Professor Mitchell's article, that of the disclosure that the well dug at the Windsor location was declared as non-commercial or non-commercial. Considering the reality of the gas seepage at the Windsor Spring, it is likely that this occurrence is a major factor behind this declaration. At this stage, my attention turns to the physical geography and geology of the Windsor Spring and immediate surrounding areas. Using this imagery as support, the Windsor Spring sits very close to the floodplain of a major river. Using this regional geologic map provided by Professor Mitchell, we can see that this St. Anne's Great River is situated near the St. Anne's Great River inlier. There also exists a fault system that pretty much lines the general direction and flow of the river. Using this larger scale geologic map as reference, what I want you to gather are the following. 1, the Windsor gas seep is situated in yellow and or white limestone. 2, there exists many faults inferred that run adjacent as well as horizontal to the general flow of the river. 3, there exists source rocks that run higher up the stream of the river. These source rocks are shales, sandstones. 4, also higher up the stream, there exists volcaniclastic rocks. These rocks have a major source being that of the igneous core, which basically is where the inliers come from. Now, if I'm going to run an imaginary cross-section from south to north, which basically is the length of the St. Anne's Great River, what we will get in terms of the rock types are the following. Volcanic clastics, we can have the sandstone and shales on top of the volcanic clastics. These are the source rocks. We can then have the limestone overlaying the sandstone shale source rocks, and this will then make the limestones the reservoir rocks. And we also will have the many fault systems. These systems are the source of migration. What is not clearly evident is that of a zone of cap rocks, or rocks that hold the hydrocarbons in place. It is likely that the yellow and white limestones could also play as cap rocks, depending on their overall lithology. However, because of the fact that there exists numerous faults, which potentially would have also been active over geologic time, and even potentially is still active today, this basically renders these said rocks as being that of, you know, permeable, and as such, they are then classified as reservoir. So in essence, the many faults potentially function more so towards the detriment of the Windsor area having commercial hydrocarbons. With this insight, let's now turn our attention to the renewed interest of Jamaica in terms of oil exploration, specifically in the offshore regions. So when we look at this satellite imagery, what it is that we should be able to see is that there exists some raised platform areas towards the southwest of the Jamaica mainland. Now, if we're going to use what it is that we have gathered from the mainland example of the Windsor Spring, what it is that we predominantly can take away is that, especially from Jamaica's history, the seafloor is home to sediments such as carbonate rocks, limestone as an example, and detrital rocks such as sandstones, mudstones. But there also exists the basement rock, being that of igneous. And in that respect, when we cross-reference that to what it is that we see at the mainland, basically the source rocks could potentially be that of both limestone and sandstones, shales as examples. Now, primarily, like the holy grail of a commercial find will be being able to source an area of trap for these hydrocarbons. Keep in mind that fault systems can be good in terms of moving or migrating the hydrocarbons from its source to an area of trap, and this basically could be a fruit in terms of economics. But it also could be bad if it's a case that there is too much fault or tectonic activity taking place, so much so that basically you just have escape, and in so doing we pretty much cannot tap it at a commercial level. This gives us insight into why the area of the Walton-Morant Basin, as an example, is of interest, specifically considering that potentially the active tectonism of this region may not be as high as that of the mainland. So in that respect, it should be a case where, on that premise, we are trying to see if there can be zones of trap that is of commercial standard. This sets the stage for interesting times ahead as regards to what is the potential of this region the Walter Moran Basin, that is, being of commercial value in terms of hydrocarbons. At this stage, let's wait and see.